Okay, so meron naman tayong another discussion for heat transfer. Mukbangin natin yung lahat na nanditong problems. So let us go with problem number one. Huwag na natin patagalin pa. So yung discussion yan is available for read of you. Ngayon, mas maganda, i-apply na lang natin isa sa problem sets na meron ako. These problems are past board exam problems and you will encounter it once na kayo mag-review na for board exam. Okay? Even sa power plant design and industrial plant design, lumalabas itong mga questions na ito. So, this is problem number one. Sabi dito, you calculate the energy, yung energy transfer rate in watt per meter squared across a 6-inch wall of fire brick with the temperature difference across the wall of 55 degrees Celsius. So, what we have there is the change in temperature, okay? Now, ang init laging pumupunta sa malamig. Hindi po ang malamig pumupunta sa init. So, the thermal conductivity of the fire brick is 0.65 BTU per hour feet degrees Fahrenheit. If you can recall, meron tayong recent discussion about this where yung kanyang conversion factor is laid out. Okay? And what is asked? Yung thermal conductivity, which is K. So, this is just a simple conduction through plane walls. What better way for us to understand it is to draw yung walls natin. So, if this is the wall, yan. I-drawing natin yung wall, okay? So, from here up to here, this is the hot side going to your cold side, where the heat transfer is always constant. Okay? So, this is the temperature of the hot side. This is the temperature of the low side. Now, the delta T is 55 degrees Celsius. Okay? Now, you are asked to find the thermal conductivity, which is K. The thickness of the wall is 6 inches. Okay? Ay, hindi. The thermal conductivity, ayun pala, energy transfer ang inaanap natin, Q. Hindi pala K. Hindi ko inintindi yung problem. So, mali ako doon. So, Q ang inahanap natin. You're asked to find Q. Now, for conduction through plane walls, meron tayong Q is equal to katex. Ka delta T over X, which is X is the thickness of the wall. Now, anong unit na ito? Tignan natin yung mga unit. The unit that is given there is in English unit. So, BTU per hour feet degrees Fahrenheit. Yung A natin, dapat ito naka-inches squared. Yung delta T natin, binigay is Celsius degree. X is in inches. Okay. So, meron na tayong given there na X, meron na tayong delta T and K. So, anong inahanap niya? Energy transfer in watt per meter squared. O, basic na yan. So, watt per meter squared, yung watt is in Q. Yung A is in meter squared. So, ang unit niya is watt per meter squared. Okay. Meron ka dyang K delta T over X. So, Q over A equal to K. Ang given there is 0.65 BTU per hour feet degrees Fahrenheit. Now, delta T. Since ang delta T natin there, tandaan nyo ito. Take note, hindi na natin uulitin. Kapag change in temperature, simple, yung Celsius degree natin, you will change it into degrees Fahrenheit. What will you do? Simple lang. Para maging degrees Fahrenheit, i-multiply mo yung Celsius degree ng 1.8. That is equal to the change in degrees Fahrenheit. How about degrees Fahrenheit to Celsius degree? Now, simple lang. O di yung degrees Fahrenheit mo, divide mo ng 1.8 para maging Celsius degree. Ah, ito yung key notes mo dyan. Okay, 0.65, so yung 55 mo, Celsius degree, i-multiply mo lang na 9 over 5 para maging degrees Fahrenheit per Celsius degree. And then, yung x mo na 6 inches. Ang problema mo dito, kailangan dito naka watt per meter squared. Yung 6 inch mo, i-multiply mo sa conversion factor niya na 1 feet every 12 inches. So, we cancel all the same units. Yung inches, Fahrenheit, Celsius, inches, maging feet squared yan. BTU per hour, feet squared. Okay. So, may matitira, di ba? Lagay natin dito. Q over A equal to 0.65 BTU per hour feet squared. Inakit mo na. Wag mo muna kumpitin to. So, 55. So, 1.8 times 55. Ano yung conversion factor nila? Okay? 6 over 12. So, 6 over 12. Kailangan to watt per meter squared. So, BTU. Anong conversion factor ng BTU? Tinuro ko nakaraan. That is 1.055 kilojoule per 1 BTU. Now, meron pa dyan yung hour mo. You have to make it in seconds. So, that is 1 hour, 3,600 seconds. And, tandaan nyo, yung magiging ano mo dito, answer mo, kilojoule per second is equal to 1 kilowatt. Okay? So, 1,000 watt every 1 kilojoule per second. Okay, may natitira pa ba yung feet squared? Nasa baba yung feet squared. O, di-multiply mo na lang dito para ma-cancel out siya. So, 3.28 yung conversion factor per meter. Feet, and then 1 meter. So, i-square mo yung value. We cancel all the same units. BTU, BTU, kilojoule, kilojoule, seconds, seconds, yung hour, hour, feet squared. So, natira watt per meter squared. So, calculate the value. Isa na lang. 0.65 times 1.8 times 55 times 1.055, sa baba na tayo, 3,600 seconds, times 6 divided by 12, that is 0.5 or 1 half, times 3.28 squared. So, the answer is, ilan? May nakalimutan tayo, yung 1,000. Napakita natin yung 1,000. So, the answer is, dapat tama. Nakalimutan ko sa kalyo. Ulitin natin ha. 0.65 times 1.8 times 55. Dapat yung 3.28 nasa taas. Nasa baba pala. Baliktad to. So, this is, balikin natin dito. Dapat to, nakaganyan. Yan. So, 1 meter. Kasi nasa baba ito, akit yan. Okay? Labas natin. 55 divided by 3,600 times 3.28 squared divide by 0.5. Yan ha. Times 1.055. Okay. Times 1,000. That is 405.77. Q is 405.77 watt per meter squared. Basic yan. Next one. Number 2. A cold storage compartment is 4.5 meters long by 4 meters wide by 2.5 meters high. The four walls, hindi to whales, the four walls, ceiling and floor are covered to a thickness of 150 millimeters. with insulating material which has a coefficient of thermal conductivity. Yan. 5 times 10 raised to the negative second power watt per meter degree Kelvin. You calculate the quantity of heat in kilojoule leaking through the insulation per hour when the outside and inside phase temperatures of the material is 15 degrees Celsius and negative 3 degrees Celsius. So, the best way for us to do it is to draw muna. Drawing natin yung ating room. So, ganyan yung nangyari. Dito, yung outside, this is 15 degrees Celsius. Laging pumupunta siya sa mainit. So, dito sa loob, ayan, sa loob, lalampas siya dun sa wall mo. May thickness yung wall na yan eh. Okay? Ganun. Project na lang natin. So, the thickness ng wall, binigay niya 150 millimeters. Tapos, this is negative 3 degrees Celsius. Inside, outside and inside phase. Okay. So, meron ka dyang 4.5. Tapos, wide is 2.5. Gano'ng kataas? That is, hindi. 4 by 4. 2.5 pala yung ano. Delete na lang natin. Okay? This is 4. This is 2.5. Ngayon, ang pinag-uusapan natin dito is the total surface area. So, the working formula here sa surface area of the pagpalagay natin prism to, parallelepiped, that is equal to balikan natin yung ating solid geometry, that is twice nung length times width plus width times height. Okay? WH na lang natin. Plus length times height. Ito yung ating working formula for surface area. Now, ang ating X is 150 millimeter. Okay. So, ganun pa rin naman yung working formula natin. Q is A, K, delta T. AK, tapos yung delta T, T hat, minus T, low. Divided by X. Okay, pareho lang siya ng katex. So, ganito na yan. Working formula muna. Q, yung A natin, surface area, we're talking about the total heat transfer. So, that is 4.5. Ganyan mo. Okay, 4.5 times 4 plus 4.5 times 2.5 plus 4 times 2. Huwag mo kalimutan yung 2. So, ang unit nito is meter squared. Okay. I-multiply mo ng K na 5.8 times 10 raised to negative second power watt per meter degree Kelvin. And then the change in temperature, so 15 minus 3 Celsius degree, change in temperature na yan, divided by X, which is 150 millimeter. Gawin na kagad nating meter para may makancel tayo. So, 150 divided by 1,000 na conversion factor niya into meter. So, meter na ito. We cancel all the same units na meron tayo, yung meter squared, meter, meter, Kelvin, and Celsius degree. Ang natira is watts. Maya natin convert. Okay? Ano yung kailangan natin para matanggal yung watts? Di ba ang watts is, dita natin. Okay. Ang watts natin, kung matatandaan nyo, you have, in every watt, okay, 1,000 joule every second, or 1 joule every second, that is 1 watt. Okay, ang kailangan nating unit is kilojoule per hour. So, you have 3,600 seconds per 1 hour. And then, yung joule natin, okay, yung joule natin ha, yung joule natin kailangan natin in kilojoule. So, you have 1,000 joule every kilojoule. So, makuha natin yung unit natin. I-cancel all natin yung units na parehas. Second. So, we'll arrive with kilojoule per hour. So, we calculate. Unahin natin taas. So, 2. 4.5 times 4. Plus 4 times 2.5. Plus 2.5 times 4.5. Ganun lang kadali yun. And then, i-multiply mo ng 5.8. Kailangan mo ulit ng parenthesis. Times 10 raised to negative second power. Naglalag siya. And then, multiply mo ng mental math mo na lang to. So, additive, 18. Divide by 150 divided by 1,000. May natitira pa ba? 3,600 o 3.6 na lang. Multiply ko na lang buo ng 3.6. Kasi nga, sir, bakit naging 3.6? 3,600 divide mo ng 1,000. So, the answer is 1966.896 kilojoule per hour. That is the answer. So, number 2. An insulated cold storage compartment is 8 meters long and 2.5 meters high across, consists of an outer steel plate. Okay? Meron kang steel plate, outer daw to. Yan yung 18 millimeters thick. And an inner wood wall, which is 22.5 millimeters thick. And the steel and wood are 90 millimeters apart to form a cavity which is filled with cork. So, ibig sabihin yung cavity na yun nasa gitna nila. So, let us draw. So, nandito si steel. Mayan natin drawing. Si cork nandito. And then, inner wood wall. So, wood. Ayan. So, if the temperature drop across the extreme faces of the composite wall is 15 degrees Celsius, so, isa lang yung naging change nila sa temperature. So, this is the drop. The change in temperature na yan. You calculate the temperature across the thickness of the cork. Take the coefficients of thermal conductivity for steel, cork, and wood as 0.045 and 18.18 watt per meter degree Kelvin. So, meron tayo ditong Q, which is constant throughout the walls. Now, yung steel plate mo, that is, 18 millimeters. Yung cork mo is 90 millimeters. Yung wood mo is 22.5 millimeters. So, the working area there is 8 meters by 2.5 meters squared. Yan yung working area mo. Ito, ang gagamitin natin, conduction to composite walls. Ganito yan. Q is equal to K A delta T over X. Ang problema, kailangan mo yung total resistance nila. Paano makukuha yung total resistance? Iba-iba ito. Uunahin mo i-solve yung total resistance bago mo ipasok dito sa entire equation. So, RT, ilan ba yung resistances natin meron dyan? So, 1, 2, and 3. Basic yan. So, unahin mo. Yung resistance is kabaliktaran. Okay? So, X sub 1, K sub 1, plus X sub 2, divide by K sub 2, plus X sub 3 divided by K sub 3. Now, nakuha na natin to. Unahin natin isolve siya. Okay. Now, yung RT natin, ganito ang gagawin mo. Okay? Yung X natin, let this as X, A, B, C. Pakita ko sa inyo sa calculator mamaya. Pero ito, solve muna natin. So, X, dapat lahat yan naka millimeter. Okay? Pero ako, lahat naman kasi nandito is in meter. Gawin ko na lang itong meter. Okay. Ganito yan. So, 18 divided by 1,000 meter na to. plus yung x sub 2 that is 90 divided by 1,000, tabihan mo na kagad ng meter. Plus, pag nakita mo na millimeter, divide mo na kagad ng 1,000 para maging meter. Okay? So, 22.5 divide by 1,000 meter divide by yung K. So, 45 watt per meter degree Kelvin plus yung susunod 0.045 watt per meter degree Kelvin plus 0.18 watt per meter degree Kelvin. So, that is it. Okay, ano yung RT natin? Solve natin. So, dito, lagay mo. Pwede kasi ganito eh. Alpha A. Alpha. Hindi, wag na alpha A. Okay, okay na yan. Lagay mo dito si 45. Plus alpha B. Okay? Tapos lagay mo yung 0.045 para hindi ka nalilito. Plus C, alpha C. Divide by 0.18. So, what is the total resistance there? You calculate. AES, pwede na tayong 18 divide by 1,000. Okay. So, next one, 90 divide by 1,000. And then, 22.5 divide by 1,000. So, ang value niya is 2.1254. Anong unit? Ang unit niyan baliktad, 2.1254. Nandito, nasa taas yung meter squared Kelvin divide by watt. Yan yung total resistance. Ngayon, ito kasi, this is Q equal to A delta T over RT. Ganyan yung magiging form niya. Okay? So, let us solve na. Sabi dito, hinahanap niya yung calculate the temperature drop across the thickness of the cork. Hahanapin mo muna yung heat that is added to the system. Same lang naman yun. Okay? The heat that is transferred to the system. So, yung Q ng outside is equal to Q inside. Equal din yan sa Q nung sa cork. Pare-parehas yan. Ang problema mo, yung temperature drop. Okay? Paano mo gagamitin? Ngayon, dito ka muna magmula sa outer. So, QO equal to, ano yung working area mo? That is 8 by 2.5 meter squared ko na to. Times temperature drop na 15 Celsius degree. Divide by yung nakuha mo na RT. So, 2.1254 para makuha mo yung total heat that is transferred to the system. So, M squared K over watt. Ang lalabas dyan is watt. May cancel kasi yan. Ganito. Okay? So, 8 by 2.5 by 15. Divide natin ng 2.1254. So, 1 for 1. 1 for 1.1499. Watts. Yan yung heat transfer. Now, hahanapin natin yun sa cork. Okay? So, yung Q ng cork, that is equal to K sa cork, delta T nung sa cork, tapos yung area, divide by thickness of the cork. Pero same lang naman dito yan. Okay. So, meron na tayong value. 1, 4, hanapin natin ha, yung delta T. Reform na natin to. So, delta T is equal to Q, C, X, C, divide by K, C, A. Yan. So, Q is 141.1499 watt. Tapos, X is 90 millimeters. 90 divide by 1,000 meters. Divide by KC, that is 0.045, kung di ako nagkakamali. Watt per meter degree Kelvin. And yung A na 8 by 2.5 meter squared. Canceling all the same units. Okay? Iaakit mo na lang to. So, matitira is degree Kelvin. So the change will be 141.1499 times 90 divided by 1,000. Ganyan lang ako mag-solve ha, pag nag, kahit sa board exam. Multiply to 8 by 2.5. So the answer will be 14.115. 14.115 degree Celsius or Celsius degree. The change in temperature pa rin yan. Next one. A heat exchanger is to be designed. Ito, common itong lumalabas sa board exam. Paulit-ulit na lang yan. A heat exchanger is to be designed for the following specifications. Okay. So, hot gas temperature, yun that will come in contact with the heat exchanger, that is 1,145 degrees Celsius. The gas or the cold gas temperature that will be in exchange, okay, yung cooling niya, that is 44 degrees Celsius. Now, the unit surface conductance on the hot side, binigay sa'yo. So, this is surface conductance, HO. This is surface conductance on the cold side. So, HI. Yeah. Now, the thermal conductivity. May nakalimutan dito. The thermal conductivity of the metal wall. So, K. That is 115 watt per meter degree Kelvin. Thermal conductance. Now, you find the maximum thickness of the metal wall between the hot gas and cold gas so that the maximum temperature of the wall does not exceed, okay, the maximum temperature. It does not exceed. So, less than or equal daw dapat. Okay? Less than or equal. 548 degrees Celsius. Now, ganito yan. I-drawing mo muna. Ako kasi dinodrawing ko yan eh. So, do-drawing ko muna yung wall. Ang inahanap dito, the maximum thickness of the metal wall, unknown si X. Yan. Now, dito yung hot side mo, meron kang airstream dito na 1,145 degrees Celsius. And then, dito yung cold side mo, that is 44 degrees Celsius. Now, meron kang surface film conductance for conduction. Okay? Conduction ba yun? Actually, conductance ata tawag dyan. Andito yan. Eh. Andito yan. Ayan. So, from fluid to wall, i-transfer. Ayan. Kailangan mo yung surface film conductance on the inside and then the outside. Ayan. So, please do mute your microphones, ha. We are on record. Yan. So, paano yon? Sabi dito, yung Q on the hot side is simply constant na lalabas dun si low side. Okay. Ganito muna ang gagawin natin. So, Q is equal to A delta T divided by 1 over HO plus X over K plus 1 over HI. Okay, ang hinahanap natin dito is X. Binigyan ka naman ng Q dyan. Actually, wala atang binigay na Q for you. Wala. So, ganito pang gagawin mo. So, QI is equal to HI A TI minus TO. Ano to? This is, may kita niyo dyan. HI HO. Eto, yan. Heat transfer from fluid to fluid. You want to measure the heat transfer on the inside and the outside. Yung merong fluid conductance to the wall. Ito yung magiging formula. Okay? Where H, yung both H are surface film conductance. Either both sides tuloy. So yung hot side and cold sides mo. Okay? So, ganun yun. Dito na tayo sa... Okay, i-measure mo muna yung sa 1. Given dito, Q, inside, inside. Yung HI mo is 230 watt per meter squared degree Kelvin. Now, meron ka ditong, ano yung came in contact dito? Yung area mo. Binigyan ka ng area dyan. Okay? The area is... Actually, walang area na binigay sa'yo. O, di-divide mo na lang to ng A. Okay? Di heat transfer per given unit area. So, TOTI. Tito, si Tito. Yung hot side mo, yung TI, sa hot side ka magmumula. TOTI pala dapat to, THTI. Okay. Try natin to. TITO. Okay. Yan. So, TOTI. Now, yung surface film, anong kukunan mo dyan? Siyempre ito, 1145. 1145. Ang common na mali dito, yung inside temperature mo, kinoconsider mo si 44 degrees Celsius. Pero binigyan ka dyan ng maximum limit for temperature. Okay? Sabi dito, the maximum temperature of the wall does not exceed. So, yun yung i-consider mo, hindi po yung cold air or yung cold gas. So, that is 548 degrees Celsius. Hindi po 44. Mamaya mo pagagamitin yung 44 kapag ginamit mo na dito. Okay? This is, kinonsider mo lang yung sa walls. Okay? Dito, pag kinonsider mo yung surface film conductance, dun sa hot gas and cold gas, i-consider mo yung maximum temperature that the wall should not get or be at. Okay, so calculate natin, Q over A. That is, QI over A yan, ha? Calculate. So, this is 230 times 1145 minus 548. The answer is 137310. Anong unit? That is watt per meter squared. Okay, hindi pa yan yung final form. Meron pa tayo sa solve dyan. Okay. Now, meron na tayo ditong working equation. Wala naman tayong given na area. So, Q over A equal to delta T over 1 over HI plus X over K equal to 1 equal to plus 1 over HO. Diyan natin makukuha yan. Okay. Gusto ko na kagad siyang i-reform na makuha ko kagad si X. Okay, algebra natin siya. So, cross-multiply natin yung dalawa. This will become 1 minus 1 over HI plus 1 over HO. Bracket mo na kagad. Plus X over K equal to delta T over Q over A. Yan. So, ito lang naman kailangan natin. Di ilipat natin sa kabila. So, X over K equal to delta T over Q over A minus 1 over HI plus 1 over HO. Kailangan natin tanggalin si K. O, di cross-multiply ko ulit ng K. Wala mang problema eh. So, X will be equal to delta T over Q A minus 1 over HI plus 1 over HO. Then multiply to K. Oh, sundin na natin siya. Ipasok na natin lahat ng value. Now, yung magiging delta T mo rito will be affected dung sa inner and outer. So, ang gagamitin ko dito, hindi yung 548. Yung 1145 and then 44. Okay? So, that is yung delta T natin. Ano muna yon? So, 1145 minus 44 degree Kelvin divide by yung Q over A na nakuha natin. 137310 watt per meter squared minus yung HI, 1 over 230 watt per meter squared degree Kelvin plus 1 over, yung binigay dyan, 290. Hindi tayo nagkakamali. 290 nga. 290 watt per meter squared degree Kelvin. I-multiply natin all of them. sa K. Ang binigay na K dito is 115. So, 115 watt per meter degree Kelvin. Ang matitira lang dito is in meter. Okay? So, i-multiply ko na lang ng 1,000 millimeter, 1 meter. Cancel all the same units. Kelvin, watt, yung isang meter. Yan, yung watt Kelvin, watt meter Kelvin. Yung watt meter Kelvin, meter ang matitira is millimeter. So, the answer will be isang pindutan na lang. So, bracket ka muna. 1145 minus 44 divide by 137,310 minus 1 divide by 230. Minus ulit kasi spread out mo dito yung sign. 1 over 290. And then you multiply it with 115 times 1,000. So the answer is 25.56 meter, millimeters. Madali lang siya. 25.56 millimeter. Ganun lang kadali. Next one. Yan na, piping. So, this is the conduction through composite pipe. Yan, nandito na yung pinaka, ano natin, alala niyan. So, a pipe with an outside diameter of 2.5 inches is insulated with a two-inch layer of asbestos. Meron tayo asbestos dyan. Binigay na yung kanyang conductance or thermal conductivity followed by a layer of cork. So, insulated with layer of asbestos, tapos susunod yung cork. And then, if the temperature of the outer surface of the cork and pipe is 90 degrees and 290 respectively, yan, respectively, calculate the heat loss per 100 foot of the insulation pipe. So, dito, papasok natin muna yung RT. Yung resistance. Kung ito yung pagkakadrawing mo dyan. Mm-hmm. Diameter ang binibigay sa'yo dyan. 2.5. Ano bang kalahati ng 2.5? So, ibig sabihin, yung 2.5 na yun, oh, yung pipe nasa loob. Ito yun, 2.5. Tapos, meron ka daw na asbestos, 2-inch layer. So, 2.5, 1.5 plus 2, di 3.25 mula center. And then, add ka ulit ng 1.5 inch thick after nung asbestos mo. So, that is 1.25 plus 2 plus 1.5, 4.75. Ibig sabihin, nandito yung cork. Ito yung asbestos. Yan. So, ang maganda dito kapag pipe, mahaba kasi talaga ang calculation nito. The best way for you to answer this is to hanapin mo muna yung RT, the total resistance. Pag piping, okay, that is yung natural logarithm nung ratio ng kanilang diameters or pwede rin yung kanilang radius. So, mauuna dito yung the bigger radius than the one na mas maliit. So, outer muna bago inner. Divide mo ng, syempre, yung thermal conductivity. Nung ano? Asbestos. Plus, LN. Nung, ilan ba yan? So, 1, 2, 3. Tatlo lang. So, you have 3, R3, R2. Divide by, pangit mo sulat. R3 over R2. Divide by, K. Nung, ano ba yun nandito sa dulo? Cork. Ayan. Hanapin natin yung RT. RT, huwag mo nang kunin yung mga units kasi malilito ka lang. LN of 3.25 divide by, ano susundan niya? 1.25. Divide by KAS, nandito yung unit niya. That is 0.396 BTU. Okay, 0.396 BTU inch per R feet squared degrees Fahrenheit plus natural logarithm of R3, that is 4.75 divided by 3.25 divided by 0.30 BTU inch per R foot squared degrees Fahrenheit. Yun ang magiging unit niya, babaliktad yan. So, RT. Huwag ka na muna mag-change dito ng unit ha, para hindi ka nahihirapan. So, calculate mo muna yung RT. So, LN, 3.25 divided by 1.25 divided by 0.396 plus natural logarithm nung 4.75 saka 3.25 divided by 0.30 kung di ako nagkakamali. So, copy mo lang yung unit. Aakit lang yung R feet and degrees Fahrenheit. So, 3, 6, huwag mo munang yan, ha, i-omit yung mga or i-round it off. 3.67787 73095. Store mo yung value nito. Okay? Store na value niya. Shift, store natin kay A. The unit is, so, hour, feet squared, degrees Fahrenheit, BTU, inch. Yan unit. So, nakuha mo na yung RT. Medyo matagal lang talaga. Ano po yung magiging total dito? Di ba Q is equal to KA delta T over X? Okay, meron ka ng resistance kasi. Tanggalin na natin to. So, you have A delta T over RT. Yung area mo dito, ano ba yung area ng cylindrical pipe? Sige nga, ano yung area ng cylindrical pipe? That is 2 pi R, di ba? Pero yung R na yun, isama na dito sa RT. So, that will be, tignan nyo dito. Yan o, may isasama na ito dito sa individual. Okay? So, magiging 2 pi L na lang times delta T over RT. Okay, kuha na yan. So, this will become 2 pi L delta T over RT. Kaya lang, ang gusto ditong mangyari is per foot. Okay, per foot daw, per foot. BTU hour per foot, per 100 foot. Binigyan ka ng length na 100 foot. So, 2 pi, 100 feet. 100 feet yan. Tapos, delta T natin, ano ba naging change in temperature dyan? 290. Minus 90. Fahrenheit degrees na to. Divide by RT na nakuha natin. So, yun nandito na value sa A. Anong unit? R, feet squared, degrees Fahrenheit per BTU inch. Okay. Kailangan maging BTU per hour lang yan. Okay. Makancel muna natin to. So, Fahrenheit degree. Si feet, yung BTU, itong inch, okay? So, you have 12 inch per 1 foot. Makancel na yung inch dito, makancel yung inch dito. Tapos yung isang feet, makancel din dito sa dalawa. Okay? So, ang matitira BTU per hour. Okay, solving. Two shift pi times 100 times 290 minus 90, 200 na lang yan. Divide by, recall natin yung value ni A, times 12. So, the answer is 2847.2911. Q is 2847.2911. BTU per hour. Ayan. So, next one. Mahaba talaga dito ang calculation. Next one. At what rate does the sun lose energy by radiation? The temperature of the sun is about 600 K and its radius is 6.95 times 10 to the 5th kilometers. So, paano ba ang radiation? For radiated heat transfer, that is equal to kuto. Okay? Kuto times E times area projected times T raised to the 4th. Saan ko nakuha yan? That is the radiative heat transfer. Nasaan po siya yung radiation? Ayan. The Stefan-Boltzmann law, sabi nga dyan, that law states that the amount of radiation from a black body is proportional to the fourth power of the absolute temperature. Where yung kuto or the Stefan-Boltzmann constant can be found using your calculator. Ano po ba yun? Excuse me. Paano mo kuha yung Stefan-Boltzmann constant? Pindutin yung calculator niyo dito. Look at it. So, shift 3. Shift constant 3, 1. Ayan, kuto. That is equal to anong unit ng Stefan-Boltzmann constant? So, Stefan-Boltzmann constant. Stefan. Constant. That is 5.67. Sapat na to. 5.67 times 10 to the negative 8 power. Anong unit? Watt per meter squared Kelvin to the 4th. In SI units. Okay? Mas madali mag-convert niyan sa English kaysa kabisaduhin mo yung English na hindi naman gaanong familiar ka. Now, dito, the area projected, what is the surface area? Nung shape, okay? Anong shape yung kinukuha natin dito? The sun, ano ba ang sun? That is spherical in form. Yung E, that is emissivity. Okay, emissivity. Okay, nakadepende yan if that is a perfect black body, a gray body, or white body. So, the black body's value for emissivity is 1, and then mas lighter, that is lower. So, what is the radiative heat of the sun? Stefan-Boltzmann constant, 5.67 times 10 raised to the negative 8 power. Watt per meter squared, Kelvin to the 4th. I-multiply natin ng emissivity niya is 1, okay, times... Anong binigay sa'yo dito? Diameter? Radius. So, ano ba ang surface area ng sphere? That is 4 pi r squared. That is 4 pi multiplied to radius na binigay niya. That is 6.95 times 10 to the 5th power kilometer to. Gagawin nating meter. Okay. So, that is km squared. Tapos, yung temperature niya. Sir, naka-absolute ba dapat yan? Yes, dapat naka-absolute siya. So, 600K. 6,000K pala. Raised to the 4th power. And then, we have to convert kilometer into meters. You have every kilometer, 1,000 meters. And then, square mo yung value. So, we cancel all the same units. Dapat ang lalabas dyan is watts. Meter squared. Kilometer squared, meter squared, okay, k to the 4th, k to the 4th. As is, lumabas yung watts. Okay, cancel. Okay, ano yan? Ulitin natin, saan makukuha yung kuto or the Stefan-Boltzmann constant or shift constant, 31. And then, multiply mo ng 4 pi times... Be careful, ha? Lagi mo lalagyan ng mga parenthesis kapag may mga power. Okay? Exponential power. So, 6.95 times 10 to the 5th times 6,000 raised to the 4th. times 1,000 second power. So the answer is 'yung nakaligtaan tayo dito, dapat 'to naka-squared. Ayan, dapat naka-squared din siya. Ayan. So Q rad. Q is 4.461 times 10 raised to the 26 power watts. Yan yung radiative heat of the sun. Next one. Calculate the radiation in watts per square centimeter. So, watts per square centimeter, dQ over A. From a block of copper at 250 degrees Celsius, the oxidized copper surface radiates at 0.6 rate of the block body. So, this is the emissivity. So, Q over A is equal to emissivity, yung kuto, times temperature to the fourth. O, wag nyo nang basahin. Okay na to, ha? Okay na yan. Wag na po natin basahin. Na basta yon, wag natin basahin. O, ibasahin nyo, tumatawa dyan, ha? Nag-aaral tayo mabuti. Ang sinasabi ko nalang, emissivity times kuto times T raised to the fourth. Wag nyo nang basahin kung ano yan. Okay? So, this is 0.6 times 5.67 times 10 raised to the negative 8 power. And watt per meter squared degree Kelvin. And then T, gawin natin tong absolute. That is 250 plus 273 raised to the 4th power, K to the 4th. Ngayon, per cm, okay, per cm. Ang lalabas kasi dito is in meter. O ilang meter ba per cm? So you have 1 meter every 100 cm. Square the value. Okay? Q over A is ang bilis lang i-calculate ng radiation. Hindi kayo mahirapan. So that is 0.6 times shift constant 31. Run, matik nandiyan na siya. Times 250 plus 273. Raised to the 4th to, divide na lang natin ng 100 squared. So, the value is 0.2545 watts per cm squared. Basic na naman. Next one. A thin square steel plate, okay, 10 cm on a side, is heated in a blacksmith's forge to a temperature of 850 degrees Celsius. If the emissivity is 0.6, what is the total rate of radiation? Ganun pa rin. Paulit-ulit. So, emissivity is 0.6 times 5.67 times 10 raised to negative 8 watt per meter squared degree Kelvin to the fourth. Tapos, in temperature niya, that is, 850 plus 273 raised to the fourth, Kelvin to the fourth. Ang problema dito, square steel plate. O ano bang area ng square? That is A squared. So, thin tuloy, 10. 10 cm squared. Okay. Kailangan natin makancel yung meter squared. Di hanapan natin ang conversion factor. You have 100 cm every 1 meter. Square din natin. So, the answer is, very basic yan. Paulit-ulit lang yung calculation mo. So, dito, inulit ko na lang. So, dito, gawin ko na lang siyang 850. May kulang pa ba ako? Yes, multiply ko na lang ng 100. Bakit? 10 squared, 100 yan. So that is 541.1054 watts basic again. Next one. A steam pipe having an outside diameter, outside surface temperature of 300 degrees Celsius passes through a room where the temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. The inside diameter of the pipe is 80 millimeters with a thickness of 10 millimeters. And emissivity factor is 0.60. Determine the radiated heat loss for a 5-meter pipe length. Basic naman na ito. So, kailangan pa ba natin consider yan? Actually, hindi na eh. Yung 5-meter length niya, yes, you have to kasi buong pipe yon. Pag piping, meron kang annular section dyan. Ibig sabihin, meron kang outside ba ang binigay? Inside diameter is 80 and then thickness is 10. Ngayon, paano mo makukuha yung area niya? The area for the piping is yung labas lang for radiative heat loss. Okay. So, yung QR natin, that is E, A, yung kuto, times T, hot, raised to the fourth, minus T, low, raised to the fourth. Ganito yan. So, QR is equal to E, emissivity is 0.60, multiplied to 5.67, times 10, raised to negative 8, watt per meter squared degree Kelvin. Multiply ko ng area. Ano ba area natin dyan? Di ba ito 2 pi L? Kasama pa ba yung R? Yes, kasama yung R. 2 pi RL. Tama ba? So pag inano mo yung surface, di ba? Surface. Kapag ito, kinat mo yung pipe na ito, buka mo na ganun. Di ba? Yung circumference nito, yun yung magiging length. 2 pi or pi d times L, 2 pi r, kailangan mo ng r. Okay, inside diameter r. Okay. So, this is 5 meters length times pi d na lang. 2 pi d. Ang diameter mo is, ginawa ko na to ah, pi d L. Okay na yan. Sa area. Sir, bakit naging ganun? O eh, ikat mo yung pipe, okay? Ito yung naging circumference, ito yung length. Yung circumference that is equal to pi d or equal to 2 pi r. Hanapin nyo sa books. Now, okay na yan. So, 100 millimeters. Bakit, sir? Kasi yung DO mo is equal to 2t plus di. Ang binigay sa'yo is di, o, 80. Tapos thickness na 10 mm. Bawat side may thickness ka. So, 100. O, divide ko na lang ng 1,000 para maging meters. Wala na kay square na value dyan. And then, multiply mo ng temperature differences. So, this will become 300. 300 plus 273, that is 573. Okay? Raised to the fourth. Minus 25 plus 273, that is 298, kung di ako nagkakamali. Mental math na lang yun. K to the fourth. Ah, K to the fourth. Ayan, K to the fourth. Dito sa labas. K to the fourth. Saan lalabas dito? Okay. Meter squared, meter squared, meter squared. K to the fourth. Watt na lang. So, QR is 0.6. Tapos, shift constant 31 times 5 pi times 0.1 times 573 raised to the fourth minus 2573. Tama naman, 298 raised to the fourth. Napataka pa ako. So, the answer is 5,339.59 watts. Basic again. Kayang-kaya yan. Next one. An insulated steam pipe passes through a room. Yan naman tayo. Insulated steel pipe. through a room in which the air and walls are at 25 degrees Celsius. The inside diameter is 55 meters, millimeters, while the outside diameter of the pipe is 70 millimeters. And its surface temperature and the emissivity are 200 and 0.80 respectively. What if the coefficient of the associated with free convection heat transfer from surface to the air is 15 watt per meter square degree Kelvin? What is the rate of heat loss from the surface per unit length of the pipe? So, dalawa ang heat transfer mo dito. Now, you have convective heat loss or heat gain, and then radiative heat loss or heat gain. So, the total heat dun sa pipe mo is Q radiation plus Q convection. Now, for the heat transfer, expand natin. QR is E, A, yung kuto, T to the fourth, plus H, A, delta T. Now, ano yung surface area natin? Di ba pipe na naman ang pinag-uusapan natin? The surface area for the pipe is pi d l. Laging ganyan yan pag pipe. So, papalitan natin yung A dito. Okay, pareho may A. O, di labas ko yung A. Magiging E, kuto, T to the fourth, plus H, delta T. O, madali lang yan. Okay. Nasaan po yung length? Nandito sa pi d, sa A. So, dito, matitira yung pi d. O, Q over length. Diba? Labas ko na yung length. So, E, O, T to the fourth, plus H, delta T. Ito, may delta T ka rin naman dito. Delta T. E to the fourth lang nilagay ko. Pero wag ka malilito. Dapat ito, T, H raised to the fourth minus T, low raised to the fourth. Ganun yun. So, Q over L. So, pi D. Ang diameter mo dyan, dapat in meters mo na para hindi ka na mahirapan. So, pi times 55 divided by 1,000. Meters na to. Okay. Yung emissivity na binigay sa'yo dyan is 0.8. Stefan Boltzmann constant, 5.67 times 10 raised to negative 8 watt per meter squared Kelvin to the fourth. Tapos the change in temperature. Ano yung change in temperature dyan? 225. So, 200 plus 273, that is 473. Raised to the fourth minus, yung 25 ulit, 25 plus 273, that is 298. Raised to the fourth. K to the fourth. Okay. Tapos, add natin dito sa H delta T. Yung H na binigay sa'yo dyan is 15 watt per meter squared degree Kelvin. I-multiply mo ng change in temperature, hindi mo na po kailangan tong ilagay sa absolute. Kasi convection and conduction di kailangan. Yung radiation lang. Absolute form dapat yon. So, 200 minus 25 Celsius degree. As is na yan, you can cancel out the same units. Okay, ano matitira dyan? Per meter. Okay, isa lang yung meter dito, isa yung meter. K to the fourth, K to the fourth, K to the fourth. Ayong K. Yung meter. Matitira watt per meter na isa. So, calculate the value. Sa loob muna tayo ng bracket. Unahin natin tong nasa dulo. So, 15 times 200 minus 25. Add natin yung value niya. 0.8. Shift. Constant. 31. Multiply natin ng 473 a loob eh. 473 raised to the fourth minus 298 raised to the fourth. Ayan. Dalawang parenthesis. And then, i-multiply natin ng 55 pi divided by 1,000. So, the answer is, basic again, 794 ba? Or may nalimutan ako? Okay. Alamin natin ulit. 0.8 to 7. Ah, the inside diameter. Okay. Inside and outside diameter of the pipe. So, ang pinimeasure natin dito, yung outside lang ng pipe. So, 70. This is 70. Hindi ko nakita. This is 70. Yan. Palitan natin lang yun dito. So, ano nga yung naging sagot kanina? Ulitin natin, 15 times 200 minus 25. Okay. Add natin si 0.8. Ayan, the answer is 997 Q total. 997.93 watts. Okay, ganun lang. Next one. Liquid, ano to? Liquid counterflow. Liquid to liquid counterflow. Paano ba nasasabing counterflow? That the heat exchanger tubes... Okay? Heat exchanger tubes, meron siyang counter-flowing na hot liquid or cold liquid. Paano mo siya gagawin? Mas maganda po kasi ito na iaan natin siya, na ido-drawing natin. Now, for overall heat exchange or heat transfer conductance, ito lang yung magiging formula niya. That is U A delta T. Where U is the overall conductance. Okay? Itong delta T, pwede itong maging, depende. Depende sa magiging turnout niya. AMTD or LMTD. Anong pinagkaya ba ng LMTD and AMTD? Simple lang, yung arithmetic kasi yung AMTD, ito is based on logarithmic changes. Kapag arithmetic, ang change mo is predictable, meron kang common difference. Kapag naman, limit, hindi to limited ha, logarithmic po, that is exponential yung nagiging changes niya. Now, ano po ba yung AMTD? AMTD, simple lang yan. Kunin mo yung delta T of the maximum change in temperature minus delta T. Ah, hindi. Arithmetic mean pala. So, that is, add mo yung delta T minimum change, yung pinakamaliit. Divide mo ng 2. LMTD, on its case, is yung natural logarithm, kukunin mo sa baba. Yung ratio ng delta T maximum change minus delta T minimum change. Divide mo ng yung logarithmic. Okay? Ni logarithm. Natural logarithm ng delta T maximum delta T minimum. Pero much better is that you draw it like this one. Okay? Throughout the length where yung x and y mo sa graph, yung x mo eh, that is the length of the tube or the piping, and then yung y coordinates mo, that is telling you the changes in the temperature. Okay? Now, pag co-current, or ibig sabihin, that is parallel flow, and then counter current, that is counter flow. Ibig sabihin, pag parallel, the same direction of the flow ng hot fluid and then the cooling fluid. Yung counter current, magkaiba ng flow sila. So, ibig sabihin, the hot fluid is going the other side and the other to the opposite side. Okay? Man lang kadali yun. Now, in this problem, ano sabi dito? Liquid to liquid counter flow. So counter flow heat exchanger is used to heat up a cold fluid from. Okay. So counter flow, meron kang cold fluid dyan. And then ito yung magiging change. Mas maganda i-drawing natin siya. If this is your temperature changes, this is the length of the fluid. Now, paano mo i-ano to? Depende sa'yo kung yung perspective. Now, meron kang unahin mo yung cold fluid, tataas yung temperature niya. From the start, ito yung magiging end, tumaas siya. Okay? So, ganun yung naging flow niya. That is for the fluid. And how about yung assuming that the hot fluid enters at 500, so mataas yung hot fluid mo, and then leaves at 400. Ibig sabihin, inabsorb niya yung naging, inabsorb siya nung cold fluid, yung heat niya. So if this is your 510, might as well mas mataas yung naging change niya. So pabaliktad. Okay. If this is 510, this is 400. And if this is your 310 ata to, 310, 120. Ngayon, i-measure mo yung naging delta T dito. Sa dulo-dulo. Then you will assess if that is the maximum and minimum. Tignan muna natin, 400 minus 120. That is 280. Degrees Fahrenheit or Fahrenheit degrees since change in temperature. Yung delta T naman, dito sa kabila, 510 minus 310, that is 200 degrees Fahrenheit. So, ibig sabihin, this is maximum, this is minimum. Okay? So, ang hinahanap dito, the log mean temperature difference for the heat exchanger. LMTD. Oh, delta T max minus delta T minimum divided by logarithmic, natural logarithm of delta T maximum divided by delta T minimum. Basic yan. So, LMTD is equal to delta T max, that is 280 degrees Fahrenheit, minus delta T min, 200 degrees Fahrenheit divided by LN. Delta T max. So, delta T max is 280 divided by 200. Check natin kung ano yung value. Okay, 280 minus 200 divided by LN ng 280 divided by 200. That is 237. Check mo sa'yo. 237. Ah, hindi. 510 ba yung binigay ko dito? O 500? Ah, 500. O, pwede na yan. 237. Tama naman yung pagkakompute. 237 and 76. So, LMTD. 237. 0.76. Degrees Fahrenheit. Okay na yun. 510 lang yung ginawa ko dyan. Okay? So, that will be yung LMTD. Now, heat exchanger. Heat exchanger has an overall coefficient of heat transfer of... Oh, meron ka daw overall coefficient of heat transfer. So, that is U. 900 watt per meter squared degree Kelvin. Now, the mean temperature difference is 20. So, mean temperature difference, so delta T. 20 degrees Celsius. And the heat loss is Q, 15,000 watts. You calculate the heat transfer in square inches. Very basic lang to. Q is equal to UA delta T. Ang hinahanap mo is A. So, A is equal to Q divided by U delta T. That is 15,000 watts divided by U, which is 900 watt per meter squared degree Kelvin. Ano bang unit ang hinahanap dyan? Square inches, basic lang yan. So, 20 Celsius degree. Oh. Ang hanapin mo dito, meter squared, aakit yung meter squared mo. So, you have 3.28 feet 1 meter times ilang feet per inches. Square inches, di ba? So, 12 inch, 1 foot. Oh, nakalimutan mo i-square to kasi naka-square yung value dito. So, we cancel all the same units. Okay? Yung feet, meter. So, square inches ang lalabas. Basic na naman. So, 15,000 divide by 900 times 20. Times 3.28 square natin times 12 square ulit natin. The answer is 129. Parang kulang ako. 15,000, o yun, kulang ako ng 0. O di times ko na lang ng 10. 1291. 1291.008 inches squared. Basic again. Next one. The mass flow rate of the freon refrigerant to a heat exchanger is 10 kilograms per minute. So, mass flow of refrigerant. The enthalpy of the entry freon is 245 kilojoule per kilogram. Exit enthalpy of the freon is 55 kilograms. So, water coolant is allowed. So, meron ka ditong condenser. So, papasok dito yung refrigerant mo. Hot refrigerant. Cold refrigerant. Tapos, meron ka ditong cooling water. Cold H2O. Tapos, meron kang hot H2O. Na mag-absorb. So, for heat exchange, Q nung ref is equal to Q ng condenser. So, M ref H R minus H low equal to MS nung water, mass flow nung water, CP of water, delta T. Yan. Delta T. Ang hinahanap dyan is kilogram per minute. Cooling water. Okay. Mass of water is equal to M rep HR minus HL divided by CP of water delta T. Ito na yung formula dun. For the mass of the cooling water. Okay. Kilogram per minute. Yung M rep mo binigay sa'yo kilogram per minute din. Tapos, HR mo, that is 245. 55 yung mababa. Kilojoule per kilogram. Divide by CP of water, that is 4.187. Kilojoule per kilogram degree Kelvin. Delta T. Ngayon, delta T mo. Allowed. Water coolant is allowed to use 10 degrees Celsius lang. So, that is the change in temperature. Okay. Cancel natin same units. Kilojoule, kilogram, Kelvin, Celsius degree. Kilojoule, kilogram. So, ang lalabas dyan, kilogram per minute. Basic again yung problem. That is 10 times 245 minus 55 divided by 4.187. Times 10. So, the answer is 45.38 kilograms per minute of cooling water. Next one. With three different quantities, yan ha, with three different quantities, XYZ of the same kind of fluid of temperatures 9, 21, and 38. So, you have Tx, which is 9 degrees Celsius. Ty is equal to 21 degrees Celsius. And Tz is equal to 38 degrees Celsius. It is found that when X and Y are mixed together, the resultant temperature is 17 degrees. Ibig sabihin, yung dalawang fluid na yun, pinag-mix mo, 17 degrees yung resultant temperature. And when Y and Z are mixed together, the resultant temperatures will become 28 degrees Celsius. Now, you find the resultant temperature if X and Z were mixed. Okay. Medyo mahirap ba? Actually, hindi. Ganito lang yan. Tandaan nyo na yung heat transfer between the three of them is always the same. Ano nagbabago dyan? Yung change in temperature lang. Pagpalagay natin, okay? Three different quantities of same kind of fluid. Ibig sabihin, if this is a heat exchange between fluids, this is in specific heat of constant pressure. So, this is isobaric yung nagiging heat change nila or yung heat addition nila. So, the transfer of heat is isobaric. Ano ba yung isobaric? Yung heat transfer niyan, that is M, Cp, delta T. Okay. Kung lahat sila merong Cp, if this is X, this is Y, this is Z, ibig sabihin, M delta T ang lalabas sa lahat ng yan. Mx equal to, ito yung delta T X, M, Y, delta T, Y equal to M, delta T, Mz, delta T, Z. Bakit sir, saan napunta yung Cp? Cancel yan kasi Cp is constant. Same fluid sila eh. Okay, so unahin natin, sabi dito, first condition, when X and Y are mixed together, the resultant temperature is 17 degrees. Okay, ibig sabihin dyan, yung magiging hot ni MX, so MX multiply to temperature resultant minus temperature ni X equal to MY, tapos M, M tuloy, TY minus TR, resultant eh. So, MX, TR is 17 minus TX na 9. Handa yun, 9 no? Equal to MY, TY is 21 minus 17. Simplify natin. M, 17, 19 or 8MX equal to 21 minus 17. I think that is 4MY. Divide natin both sides by 4. Para makuha natin si MY. So, MY is equal to 2MX. Okay. Condition 1.
Hello?
Okay. So, let's continue. That is the condition 1. Second condition, nagbigay siya dyan. When Y and Z are mixed together, the resulting ones are 28 degrees Celsius. Okay. So, MY, T resultant minus TY equal to, titignan nyo naman kung saan yung mas mataas eh. Okay? Tapos, MZ, so TZ, tapos minus TR, yung resultant. So, MY, yung temperature resultant niya that is 28 minus 21 equal to MZ, as 38 minus 28. Simplify natin. 28 minus 21, that is 7MY equal to MZ as 28 and 38, that is 10. O, simplify natin. Pwede na to. Okay? Pwede na to. Condition number 2. Now, pwede natin to i-simplify para makuha natin si MX. Meron pa bang sinabi yung resultant? Ah, find the resultant temperature. So, yun yung hanap natin. So, pagpalitin ko dito si Z and si MY. Ayan, pwede dito. Substitute ko dito sa 2, si 1. So, 7MY 2MX is equal to 10MZ. So, this will become 14MX equal to 10MZ. So, na yan. Condition natin. Pagpalitin na lang natin mamaya. Ang hinahanap natin dito, MX, temperature resultant minus TX equal to MZ tapos TZ minus TR. Inanap natin is TR between the two. Okay. Ito, pwede mo to i-reform na MX equal to 5 over 7 mz. Yan. So, pwede natin itong i-substitute sa mx dito. So, 5 over 7 mz tr. Yung tx natin is 9, kung di ako nagkakamali. Okay, 9. Equal to mz. Yung z is 38 minus tr. We cancel yung parehong mz. Cross multiply natin. So, 5 tr minus 9 equal to 7 38 minus tr. Makuha na natin si tr dyan. So, 5 tr minus 45 equal to 7 times 38. That is 266. Minus 7 TR. Pagsamahin natin yung parehas. So, 7 TR plus 5 TR equal to 266 plus 45. Divide natin both sides by 7 plus 5 para makuha na natin si TR. So, TR is equal to 266 plus 45 divided by 12. So, the answer is 25.92 degrees Celsius. Ganun lang po yun. Algebra lang. Diba? Next one. An economizer receives hot gas and water in the ratio of 1.5 pound gas per pound water. The gas enters, so meron ka dyang mg divided by ms or m water, mw na lang. That is 1.5 pound per pound. Ito gas, ito water. The gas enters at 845 degrees Fahrenheit and leaves at 352 degrees Fahrenheit. The water enters at 120 degrees Fahrenheit and find the exit temperature of water and the LMTD for the parallel flow if there are no external energy losses. Okay, ganun lang naman yun. Q gas is equal to Q water. So, M gas, Cp gas, T hot minus T low. Meron kang entry and exit. Sa gas to, equal to M water, Cp water, okay? Tapos, temperature hot nung sa water minus temperature low ng water. Ito yung hinahanap natin. Ito, yung M gas, divide natin ng MW. Okay? Para makuha na natin. So, paano yan? So, meron ka ditong, cancel na to eh. Dito mapupunta yan. So, 1.5 pound per pound. Huwag mo nang kunin yung unit. So, Cp of the gas, that is 0.27, sabi dito. BTU per pound degree Rankine. In temperature niya, that is 845. Tapos, yung leaving temperature niya, 352. Divide by Cp of water, that is, kapag English unit, 1 BTU per pound degree Rankine. Equal to temperature sa water minus temperature low water. Kaya lang, temperature low ng water, that is, hindi ako nagkakamali ha, binigay na 120. Okay, natin 120. So, lipat ko na lang to sa kabila. So, T hot water equal to 1.5 times 0.27 times 845 minus 352. Divide by, huwag na natin lagay yung 1. Okay, 1 degrees Fahrenheit plus 120 degrees Fahrenheit. Ang lalabas dito is degrees Fahrenheit. Check natin. So, 1.5 times 0.27 times 845 minus 352 plus 120. The answer is 319. 319.665 degrees Celsius. Ngayon, drawing natin yung kanilang turnout sa... Oh, ito yung length, ito yung temperature. Na yung water, it started at 120, umakyat daw ng 319. Ngayon naman, lumamig naman yung gas. Okay? From 845 dito. 845 as naging 352. Ibig sabihin, parallel flow sila. So, ito yung delta T, delta T. So, alamin muna natin, 845-352. LMTD. LMTD. Delta T max, delta T min, divide by ln of delta T max, delta T minimum. Yan. Masolve na natin yan. So, isahan na lang ha. Isang pindutan na lang. So, alam ko naman na 120 and 845 will yield yung mataas na value for temperature change. So, 845 minus 120 minus 352 minus 319.665. Divide natin ng ln of 845 minus 120. Pwede rin kasi ito maging counter flow. Kaya itatry mo yung dalawa. Okay? Pero ako, nakuha ko naman sa answer key yung tamang sagot. Kaya alam ko tama ito. So, 352 minus 319.665. Pero kapag wala sa choices, itry mo yung other way. So, maging counter flow siya. So, that will become 222.72 or 223. Temperature LMTD. 222.76. Approximately 223 degrees Fahrenheit. That is the answer. Ay, nako. So, that will be yung ating ano na lang, ating discussion for today. So, I leave yung 2 para practice niyo on your own. That will be all. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.